When it comes to commercial snow removal, look to Tovar Snow Professionals. With the largest snow and ice management fleet in the Midwest, Tovar delivers top-notch commercial sidewalk and parking lot clearing services, even in winter's worst weather conditions. With their 24-hour live office staff, certified meteorologists, and personal service, they are leaders in professional snow removal. To get a free estimate for snow removal on your site, go to baseball.tovarsnow.com or call 844-GO-TOVAR. That number again is 844-GO-TOVAR. Tovar Snow Professionals, Chicago's snow plowing leader. Tovar is an equal opportunity employer.
Roll in. Keep those doggies. William, where are
rolling,
you going to be?
Rolling. Rawhide.
Where are you going to be next Wednesday
Crystal
night?
Crystal
July
Lake Brewery.
21st. Wednesday night, July 21st.
Crystal Our Lake home Brewery. Bar. The home bar of Club 400 Ballpark Lager.
Live podcast, ticket giveaway, swag giveaway, Cubs game on at 7 o'clock. We're going to be speaking to the main man, Ryan Clooney, the beer master himself. We're going to speak to the owner, John O'Fallon. We're going to have a good time. Now, this is where the Club 400 Lager is brewed, William.
It is unbelievable.
So we want
It's like us going home. It's a homecoming of
this
sorts.
This is a homecoming show. We want you to show up. We want you guys to wake Crystal Lake Brewery up and say, oh, my God, they are somebody. The Club 400 crew comes in, and they come in and attack, and boy, do they know how to drink some beer, right, William?
Yeah, are they going to have that on tap that night?
Club 400 on tap. If you come up to me and you say, Cub fans helping Cub fans, I'll buy you a Club 400 draft.
Oh, you can't beat that.
That's
so
the tip of the night.
So join us
next Wednesday. That is July 21st, Crystal Lake Brewery. We start at 6. Come early. Get your table. Win some Cub tickets. Win some Club 400 swag. Hang out with William. Get him drunk. Uber his ass home. We'll love to see you there. All right, guys?
Yeah, what we want to do is make sure we're all wearing Cub stuff, too. We're going to cheer for this team no matter who the team is.
That's right. Hey, fire sale. Let's celebrate the fire sale. Come on, guys.
Baseball's America's pastime.
Baseball.
You're listening to Club 400 Podcast, a show about Cubs fans for Cubs fans. Be sure to follow us on social media. We're active on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
Live from Club 400, we are back, William. We're back in the saddle.
So good to be back.
We've been on the road, William. We started off at good old
road tripping.
Parkside.
Parkside Pub, right here in Huntley, Illinois.
Had a great time out there with good old JR. And then we headed out over to where they served Club 400 drafts perfectly.
Bricks and Ivy. What a place, huh?
And now, as you heard
intro, night.
We will be headed at Crystal Lake Brewery next Wednesday.
So excited.
I'm asking you guys, this is an ask from me. Please show up.
You know what? It was almost like our first two shows were like a warm-up for this, right?
Well,
this
pretty is a much, big one. Pretty much was. I mean, we're going home. This is where the beers brewed.
I mean,
this is where it all went down.
Obviously, once the road show hits Wrigley Field and we're doing a show from Wrigley, that's when we've hit the pinnacle. But as far as local pinnacles, this is a big one.
This is important to us. Great relationship with Crystal Lake Brewery. The staff is going to take care of you. Beth and the crew, and John's going to be in the house, and
I'm hoping to hear some stories about you with your head in the, what do they call that? The bin where you mix the beans and shit. And
we've had some good times in the back room. That's for sure.
Some good times. I had my second Malort shot in that back room.
I do remember that. The bottle is still back there, by the way, for obvious reasons. I mean, we love Malort, right, William? Speaking of Malort, we're going to have a lot of Malort here this Sunday, and we're going to have a lot of Jägermeister. As Club 400 welcomes Frank Walker and the security team at Wrigley Field. We're going to have about 20 to 30 people that work at Wrigley on the security side come out here. We're gonna have a ballpark. It's better than a ballpark lunch. We're not just giving these guys hot dogs and bags of chips. We're going first class. I mean, these guys are the people that make Wrigley Field move. And
It probably will be the safest place in America on Sunday.
Exactly. Club 400 will be the safest place ever. We have 20 to 25 people who could throw your ass out in a heartbeat.
Yeah, they could throw. Now, what if you get out of hand? Can they throw you out of your basement?
I don't think they can. Have you ever been thrown out of a ballpark before, William?
One time.
Okay, tell us this quick story. Make it quick, because we got a lot of things to cover.
Very quick.
Including the Club 400 Wrigleyville. I mean, we'll talk about that, right?
We will talk about that in depth. One time I was thrown out of a ballpark, Minnesota Vikings at Green Bay Packers at Lambeau Field. Brett Favre's returned to Lambeau Field. Got a little obnoxious. Let me put it to you this way. It was a Sunday night game. I got there Thursday night. We were in an RV from Thursday night till Monday. And, you know, just kind of got out of hand towards the end of the game, threw some beers up in the air.
Well, you know,
hit the victory, and they walked me out. It was fun. I got the Bronx cheer. It was all worthwhile. And actually, I didn't get thrown out. I just got taken out of my seat. The usher was like, "You didn't do enough to get thrown out, but if I were you, I wouldn't go back to your seat." So we'll have to ask them on Sunday, like, for some good stories about people they've had to throw out.
I know.
I don't know if they'll be able to tell us. I don't know if there's any, you know, statutes of limitations or, you know.
By the way, Frank Walker has a podcast out, which we've been on, called Mistaken Identity. And basically he's interviewing people that work for the Chicago Cubs and telling their story. Great idea. And you know what? Frank is really making that group a family. And it's pretty awesome what he's doing over there with all the great things he's done throughout the last year. He's bringing the crew together and doing awesome things. So congrats to Frank. And if you ever get the chance to listen to his podcast.
Yeah, and you know, a common theme that you have all the time on this show is talking about how, you know, individually, you know, we're not much of anything. But when you put all these different pieces together of all the different Cubs factions, you know, across the globe here. Frank was at our show, our last live show.
Yeah, he came out the last
show. And actually shot a video about coming out to our show.
Right.
To help promote his show, but, you know, like, we were part of that. So that was really cool.
Frank's becoming a great friend of Club 400, and we're really looking forward to everybody coming out.
Are we going to haze him and indoctrinate him into Club 400 on Sunday?
We're all going to have to do a shot of either Jaeger or Malort. I was told that these guys know how to party, which I was like, oh, these guys aren't going to party. But then I had to go out and buy 15 cases of Club 400 beer and a fresh keg. The bar is stocked. We are ready for you. I promise you guys.
Speaking of videos, how about the video that you posted on our Facebook page about, well, it was starring Carol Haddon.
Awesome.
How great was that?
Awesome. As you know,
see that one coming.
Carol, yeah. I knew they were doing a piece on her. Wasn't sure the angle that they were taking, but it obviously made sense. Obviously, Carol, longest tenured season ticket holder, lost her husband, Jimmy, from COVID. And it kind of talked about her going back to the Cubs game for the first time, experienced the loss of her husband. Terrible.
And if they put on the credits at the end, like who that piece was starring, it was starring Carol Haddon and probably David Ross.
Exactly. So
that's not bad. Not great. Bad company to be in.
I posted it on all the pages, so check it out if you haven't. The number one question I've been getting lately, and I haven't really addressed it, because of Club 400 Wrigleyville, I've been working on that, but, we'll talk about that in a minute, is Sean Dunstan. Sean Dunstan is coming. I had called Sean to schedule the date, and he said out of the blue they decided to move. So they're in the process of buying and selling a house. So as soon as he said it wasn't planned. It was kind of just one of those things in life where you just do something.
As soon as he moves, we'll post his address.
Yes, yeah, exactly. As soon as he moves, we'll get him back out here. But he wants to come out. We're good. I'm working on another event right now. Our first event, and I'll tell you, William, it will be special when I book that first event back. And we're hoping it's going to be for the clone family, Eddie and Riker. And, we're going to do something. I got 5 fishing poles in the water, William. That's always good. I got some nibbles right now. I got a few bites. I got a few people. We're going back and forth right now.
Deep sea fishing.
And I do want to say one thing. I mentioned it a while ago. I do, just because of the timing of everything, like when we have our first event back, I'm pretty much thinking we're not going to go full bore at like 300 people. I think like we're shooting for maybe an event for like half that. And maybe in September or October. That's what I'm kind of thinking right now.
Yeah, 2022 seems more like the appropriate time.
I mean, we can have a couple smaller ones, obviously. But I'm talking about big ones. But I just want to let everybody know, like, the event for mental health is, I mean, I want to take care of the Colon family first. They've fallen under some things that are going on right now. I want to take care of them first. And then when we do our big blowout, it'll be for mental health. And I want to get some players that are behind the cause, obviously, with maybe Ian Happett or whatever. So, but yeah, we're working on that. And I'm excited about it because like I said, we're going back and forth right now with a few players. So, look forward to that announcement. Nibbles. And this show is being recorded. We're headed to Eric Church tonight. William, you're going to get countryed up tonight.
I called my mom and I told her I was going to church tonight. She was proud of me. That's what she said. I'm proud
That's
of you.
That's awesome. And William, you're not really a country guy.
I listened to Eric Church all day today.
So you got a drink in your hand?
I got a drink in my hand.
You like...
I like Springsteen.
You smoke about it, drink about it.
I like that,
Get a little high, smoke a little joint, smoke a little smoke. I should know this. Sorry.
He also sings a throwback song called Chevy Van. I'm not sure if you're familiar with that, but it's a...
Round Here Buzz. We should end tonight with a Eric Church song.
Eric Church, I like
should
it. Do that. Yeah, so. Let's do that.
But anyways, you guys saw it on the Facebook page, and you know, let's be honest with you, okay? I bought a condo.
We're gonna need a jingle for this. We don't have it yet, but we're gonna have to have
condo
a
condo jingle.
We're gonna have to have a Wrigley Club 400 Wrigleyville jingle.
Now is Club 400 coming to Wrigleyville? No, not really. I mean, I'm living in a building with six other people in that building.
Do they know what they're in for?
I mean, that's why I don't want to say anything until this deal is done, because then they might ban against me and ban me from the building. So we won't give out any addresses or anything. But
you'll become good friends with them, I'm sure.
No, honestly, I will say this before I go into what is going on here is, I respect my neighbors here. I respect my neighbors there. That's the main thing. This is not a situation where it's like you're living in a big house with a bunch of other people. So you got to respect the whole crew. But anyways, an opportunity, and I have to thank Club 400's own Kathy Wheatley, who we've talked about many a times. Come through big time. Basically, I had even reached out to Brad in the past from the Heckler and said, because he's a realtor, obviously, and to certain people and said, hey, if you find a place, let me know about it. If a good deal pops up or whatever. And Kathy reached out to me and she said, Stu, I found your condo. I said, what are you talking about? You found my condo. She's like, you're going to buy it. I can't wait till you see it. So she's like, we got to get you a parking spot. She like acted like I had it before I even had it. So I basically went down there and looked at it, and I wanted it right away. I'll tell more of the story later, but I wanted it right when I saw it. It's a perfect location, not far from Wrigley Field, 2 bedrooms, bath. And what it's basically going to do for Club 400 is, obviously, it's a place where we can meet some friends before and after the games. But, we can use it as our auction items for our auction presents instead of for when we raise money. Like, for instance, instead of giving away just cup tickets to a game, we can give a weekend at Wrigley Field, and we can use it for the players when they come in, and Club 400 members can have access to it if it's not being used for a particular weekend. So it's just a place, if you have to take a dump, William, and, maybe you can just sneak over and take a dump.
Now, quick question, will you have ample toilet paper and will it be Charmin?
Well, William, the only problem with this apartment is it only has one bathroom.
Okay.
So that's not good for you.
Do you want me to manage that, though?
I would like you to manage, yes. The toilet paper spot, yep.
There's always toilet paper there.
So basically, I got to close on it first. And then, basically we're going to use it sparingly for the rest of the season. Put the minimum in there. And then we're going to Club 400 it up. Of course we are, William. What do you think it's going to look like, a condo? No, it's not going to look like a condo. I can promise you that.
Now you can buy more stuff.
I have enough stuff. So we're going to knock down a wall. We got to get permission. We're going to do everything legally here.
I think the third thing you ever said to me was, after I was here probably my third time, you're like, yeah, my wife told me I can't put any more stuff down here. I can't get any more stuff.
I have enough to do your basement when you're ready, and Crowley's if you need to. I mean, Crowley's got his basement going right now. Right. I'm really excited about it. It's a dream come true. It'll be, for the hardcore members that listen to this podcast, that come to all the events, you know who you are. It'll benefit you. It'll benefit us. I look at it as a us thing. I don't look at it as a me thing. That's just the way I am. When I thought about buying this place, it was for the club. I'm like, this is perfect for the club. Let's say, Patty and Ruth and Dave, because they're a threesome, as we all know.
A thruple.
a thripple. Let's say they want to go down there for the weekend.
Yeah, perfect.
Use the place. Go ahead. Mm-hmm. Go ahead. So, no, it's going to be great.
Kind of inspired by the rooftop.
Yeah. And you know what? The whole thing, 1050 Wrigleyview.com, Wrigleyview.com, that's the only place to see a rooftop, William.
It's the only place.
Our guy, Aiden. So, yeah, I mean, hanging out there a lot and just staying on the second floor apartment.
And I mean, when you get to stay down there and you don't have to go anywhere and you get up the next morning and you can go to breakfast before the next game or whatever, yeah, it's just a whole different deal.
So I was down there at Wrigleyville. I stayed in Aiden's apartment. And Aiden fell asleep and forgot to give me the keys. So I got back at 2:30 in the morning.
Oh, hmm. And what were you doing?
I was out and about carousing.
Carousing.
But... I was actually tearing up some Wrigleyville bars. I'm not gonna lie, because I don't get the opportunity to stay out late at the bars because I gotta get home. So I come back. It wasn't 2:30 because it was more like 1:30. But I came back and I had no keys. I couldn't get in. I end up scaling the wall to get up. I end up scaling to get like the second floor.
Does
balcony.
He have security camera footage on that?
I was right by the fire station. I swear to God, once I got up there, I was proud of myself for getting up there and being able to climb up that much. But like as soon as I got up there, I like totally looked around to see if anybody saw me because they'd think I was trying to break in or something.
I'm going to ask Aiden if he does have security camera footage. We'll post that if he's got it.
He laughed about it yesterday, but I was like, man, next time, can you give me the keys maybe? Or don't go to bed at 10:30, Aiden, you know?
That would be easier. Just give me the key.
Jeez, but yeah, so Club 400 Wrigleyville, it's just an extension of Club 400. No, we're not throwing any wild parties. We're not doing any player signings over there or anything like that. This is a residential, but it will benefit some of you members. We'll have some drinks over there before and after some games. And it's going to be a bar. I'm putting a bar in there. It's going to be two bedrooms and a bar. That's what we should call it, two bedrooms and a bar. William, I'll have you a bed. You'll be ready to go.
Excellent.
So really exciting, a dream come true. Thank you, Kathy Wheatley. Probably next year, opening day, I'm thinking, we'll have a little get-together there.
Ribbon cutting ceremony.
Yeah, exactly. And it'll give us all winter long to tweak it. So.
Tweak.
So, yeah, and I have to. I think I want to get an updated Club 400 logo that says Club 400 Wrigleyville. How's that?
I like it.
So that's awesome.
Shirts too.
Really, yeah, exactly. Really happy to have it. It's going to change, you know, I'm a Bears season ticket holder too. And not to mention the concerts and, you know, the amount of times I go down there, it just makes a lot of sense. I can put my office in there. And speaking of big news, we're not going to talk about it tonight, but we will have an announcement soon. We are growing Club 400. It's getting bigger, and it's going to get better, and we're bringing someone in to help in a big way. So we'll talk about that on the next show. Really excited for it, and you're going to see things and be like, whoa, what's going on here? What's going on here? And it's all the things I want to do, but I don't have time to do.
It's going to be like you multiplied into multiple people.
Exactly. There's so many things that I want to do that I haven't been able to do. Because, as you guys all know, Club 400 is not my business. It's my passion, but it's not my business. So I'm really looking forward to having someone come in here and dedicate themselves and do the things that we've talked about. We're going to step our apparel game up. I want to get nice golf shirts and nice girl shirts, not just T-shirts and nice hats and the Club 400 vodka that we talked about, things like that. And you might see some more events around that are going to be happening. But just really looking forward to it. We'll have a podcast with that news soon. But we're growing. We're growing, and we're going in a positive direction. And by growing, that means we get to help more people, William.
And as you mentioned, Club 400 is your passion, not your full-time job. I just want to put a little PSA out there, Mr. Ricketts. We still are available.
We are available
for hire for the Marquee Network.
Because God knows you need like a liaison to the fans. I don't think you have one right now.
Yes, yeah, so we're available. So
especially because we got the new condo, William.
Right. So we can have meetings right by you. You can walk.
You can call us in the office because William probably screwed up and said something stupid.
Right. Yeah.
We can report to the office right away.
We can come right over.
Mr. Ricketts, we are available for hire.
We're here. We're available. We're here, ready to go. And especially if you get rid of players like Jack Peterson and others, you'll probably need somebody like us to help, continue to raise the cred of the Cub.
So, true. Very true. William, I got a checklist here, and we got to get going.
Mm-hmm.
Lisa just gave me that. We got to get going, sign.
Yeah.
But we are drinking right now.
It's almost church time.
And almost church time. And Hardy, my guy Hardy's playing tonight. This is very important, guys, okay? Because the game's going to change real soon. Todd, we're going to have him on from Stadium Events. He's supposed to be with us, but then William decided to ditch me 3 nights in a row to do the podcast. So, but anyways, Todd was going to join us today, but he couldn't join us at this particular time because at this particular time, we didn't know it was going to be this particular time because William shows up late, whatever else. But anyways, the Stadium Events, our road trip to St. Louis, October 1st, 2nd, 3rd. Unlike in the past, I don't know who signed up. I don't know who's going. But all I can tell you is this. We don't have that many, but we have all these people that are saying they're going. But at this point in time, money talks, bullshit walks. So basically, Todd is going to open it up to the general public. And I told him, give us another week or two. So let's say end of the month, okay? Let's say July 31st. If you're not signed up, this is going to go public.
No guarantees.
And then all we're going to get these baloney people we don't know on this trip.
We don't want that. No baloney.
So I don't know who signed up. I know a lot of people want to go or are talking about it and trying to find roommates.
Isn't Raybone Burris going?
Big news. Raybone Burris is headed with us to St.
On the bus.
Louis. On the bus, there and back. He's a part of the whole entire trip, dude. Now, I called Raybone in Florida, and I said, Raybone, how about you join us? By the way, Raybone is joining us also for the tailgate party in Milwaukee with Danny Rocket.
Unbelievable.
He'll be there with us. So I called Raybone. I said, Raybone, I want to invite you to St. Louis. And he said, oh, my gosh, what are you going to do there? So about 50 Club 400 members are going down there on a bus. And I said, I could fly into St. Louis and fly out. Oh, Stu, what good is that going to do? I'll miss the bus. That's the funnest part, right? And I'm like, you're right. It's the funnest part, right? All right. Fly me out there, and I'll get on the bus with your house. Okay, Ray. You know what? I'll tell you what I do. I'm going to be a really nice guy to you, Ray. I will fly you home from St. Louis to Florida, and you don't have to do the worst part, which is the ride home. Oh, no, Stu. Oh, no. I'll ride the bus back, man. If I'm going hardcore. I'm doing the whole trip with you guys.
Love it.
You got to love Raybone, don't you?
You got to love it. This is his first year off in like 100 years, so he's pretty excited to have some free time.
I mean, it's not too often you get to hang out with a Cub the whole entire weekend, and I promise by the end of the weekend you're gonna think, yeah, he's a part of your family.
Right.
That's the way he is.
He is, and he's got stories. Oh, my goodness. He could talk the whole time. So, like, we don't have to say anything.
What do I have to do? Beg you guys to come on this trip? You know, yeah, like... Go. We have it hooked up unbelievable. Like, real quick, let's go over it. Basically, we're going to leave Friday morning, get to the hotel. The bar has gave us a specific area with two wait staff. They're allowing us to bring Club 400 Lager inside. Free Club 400 Lager whenever you're in that bar at the designated times that we have set. And then if you want anything else, like mixed drink, whatever else, you start your own tab, basically. All right, then we head to the game Friday night where we... watch the game, obviously, and then Friday night we actually have it set up in the bar when we get back, so we have Club 400 beer in there. Saturday morning we wake up. If you want to go to the Budweiser Brewery Tour, great. We're going to head over there, do the brewery tour. The cost is already included in your ticket price. Then they're going to come back to the hotel where there's going to be a party going on in the bar with Club 400 Lager. Then we are going to leave on a bus and head directly across from Busch Stadium and tailgate for 3 hours.
Will there
burgers,
be beer
brats,
on the
hot
bus?
Dogs. Oh, beer everywhere.
Beer everywhere.
And then
it's St. Louis. It's boring.
I mean, basically, you're going to use your bed to sleep in, and that's about it.
Well, which means you and I are sleeping together then.
I'm trying to find out if Lee's is going or not, but if not,
matter.
I will jump in with you and Crawley. I don't care.
It doesn't matter. It could be me, you, Lisa, and Crawley. Whatever.
So join us for the road trip. I mean, come on. What else you got to do? It's October 1st, 2nd, 3rd. Who cares if the Cubs are in last place? It's not about the Cubs right now. It's about getting together and partying.
Right.
Let's be honest, right, William?
Right.
I mean, geez.
Kick COVID's ass. Let's go.
I mean, yeah. I mean, Todd always does a great job. It's a great trip. You basically get off the bus. Well, basically, when you get on the bus, you know, you're in for one hell of a time. And
fantastic.
True or false, William? Did we not? Was it because of our road trip, our two people getting married? Do you think it has anything to do with it?
Oh,
no?
Totally.
So tell them. Go ahead, William.
Totally. George and Holly?
Yeah, George and Holly. Well, on our last road trip, yeah. They were like banging on that. Should I say that out loud? What they were
you
like.
You already did.
They were like.
You already did. Yeah, you're good. And they won't mind.
And and then now they're getting married. It was all because of the Wild Bunch.
Yeah.
I mean, that Wild Bunch old club. Jeez. I'm not even drunk yet. I'm not even drunk.
We're going to church tonight. So
I just got the Wild Bunch newsletter in the mail, so I was thinking about them earlier today. So I think that's it, William. We wanted to do this short podcast for a couple different reasons. We wanted to promote the CLB podcast, tell you that it's important to us that you show up. And maybe you can win some cup tickets. And if we get a really good turnout, I'll give away two sets of tickets. And my seats, section 122, row 7. Not bad at all.
Pretty good.
Sean Dunstan's coming. We got a big addition coming to Club 400 to grill this thing, get us all the good things that you guys want. And we got an event we're going to announce soon. So good things ahead. Get on that road trip and come out with us. Appreciate all you guys. William, you got anything to say? You got your country cowboy hat on tonight or what?
I do. I've got my cowboy hat on. I've got my Eric Church songs memorized, and I'm ready to go. You ready to hit it?
All right. How about we play Smoke a Little Smoke right here? What, you have one already?
I had one already, dude.
All right, you pick it.
I've been listening all day. All
right, I want to hear it. Hey, see you guys Wednesday night. Wednesday night, Crystal Lake Brewery.
Be there.
I will put a beer in your hand. All you got to do is come up to me and say, Cub fans helping Cub fans. We love you guys. Take care.